Okay, friends, subscribers, yeah, because I've got people, bombarding me with questions and things like that. Charity of faith. If I could really, really bring something back from my other world, as you know, as a victim, it doesn't work like that. I don't know whether it is our spiritual conscience that is being moved. Something is being moved, but I know, I do think, yes, it's our bodies as well. But what's happening in the translation between planets or whatever, I don't know. Yes, I'm pretty sure it was you that asked about the rapture. Yes, if you were from my world, you would have known where Tall Red was, because it's in this same country as, I think it's called Andorra. I'll try and bring up a map for you. But the thing is, it's in the same, exact same bloody place as here. Where is it? There we go. Right there. Okay. Charity. Andorra. In this reality. Okay. Why won't that move? Okay, something's going on with my window, folks, and just bear with me. I'm trying to move it for charity. Okay, that little country there, that's where Torred is, in there. That little country there is Torred. Forget about that name there. But that's my reality. In this reality, that's what it's called. All right, you've got to understand that... I don't know how it's happening. I'm still trying to investigate it, the same as everybody else. The thing is, none of us know for sure what's causing this. All we know is that it's happening. And the reason why I'm putting this background up, right, with the thumbs up and the demonetized symbol in it, is because of the simple fact that I believe that all YouTubers should demonetize your videos. The only way to fight YouTube back is with the exact same tactic they're doing. Right? You got to think about it. They make money, they make more money than we do out of advertising. They make twice the amount that we make. We get a third of it, remember? We only get one third of what they make. So, you think about it, the more videos, now, because not all of us have been affected with total demonetized, like some channels already have been, and they're slowly going through all the channels. God, you've only got to say one thing wrong and they're going to demonetize your videos. I guarantee you, I'm going to demonetize mine before I can. You've got to forgive me. I've got a few channels that I've got to demonetize, because Bluebeard 2011 has never just been my only channel. I've got lots of complaints, I've got other ones, and I'm trying to do them first. Because all my faithful subscribers are here on Bluebeard 2011, and you've all missed me, and yeah, the other people on my other channels haven't missed me that much. I haven't been getting the responses that I've been getting, and trust me, guys, I love you all too, man. I've missed you all as well, because I went to a world where... it wasn't called the Mandela Effect, and it really wasn't, because I don't know whether it's the distance or whatever, or how it actually works. That I still don't know. All I know is that it is us that is moving. It is not the logos changing. If a logo says it's been like that all these years, it has on this planet, in this reality, in the multiverse. You need to start referring to this as being shifters. All right, from now on, I'm going to add the word shifter into our vocabulary, because we're the ones that are shifting, not the artifacts, not the films. It's us. We're the ones being shifted. I don't know whether this is some giant alien experiment, because I can tell you now, on my home world, The main conspiracy was it was aliens that abducted everybody in one day. There was, in the Christian community, that God did it. Right, so there were two versions of it. And yes, of course, the Christians are all going to say, yeah, it was God. One of my kids is a Christian. And yes, it was God. But the others, they carried a vigil and eventually my kids got together. But maybe that was, this is the miracle that my family needed. Because see, when I was growing up, I had a lot of, I was called a root rat. And in Australia, it's called a root rat. If you screw around with different girls, you're called a root rat. Unfortunately, I had a child to each marriage, and I had a child to a friend that was from a one-night stand with her. Even though we'd known each other for many years, we just got drunk. We had a beautiful daughter. That's the first one that I saw when I got home. And it still, you can hear it in my voice. It still cracks me up because the moment I saw her, I just burst out in tears. And I really did. If you've ever seen a grown man cry, I was crying worse. Right? I actually saw my daughter, and it hurt. It's sort of like, just even like I was glad, but there were tears of joy, and it's still tears. There's still tears of joy, but they're also tears of sadness again, because she's gone again. So you've got to understand that. But the whole thing is, it's sort of, no, I've lost track now because I've been talking about my kids. But the Mandela effect and everything is one thing. It's us that are shifting. It really is. It's us. We're the ones shifting. Okay, you've seen different things and everything like that. The Great Wall of... this one got me. The Great Wall of India. Right? This one really got me. The Great Wall of India. Right? Because it... spun me right out. It really, truly did. I don't even know if I actually, and I've got to say this, I don't know if I'm actually back in the same reality I left just after Christmas, because I'm finding things here that are different again. This is why I said, give me a couple of days. I wanted to look at everything. I don't know if all of you have shifted with me or shifted at the same time, or you got here before me. What's happening to our counterparts? I don't know, but they exist. I can tell you now, because I've been keeping a journal in pretty much everywhere. It's a private journal just for me and me and me and me, whoever they are. And I'm about to be hassled by my dog again, who just won't leave me alone since I've been home. And, darling. All right. And the whole thing is, it's, you've got to now consider yourself like a shifter. It's sort of, not like a shifting spanner, but a shifter like in that film, that TV show. We're the ones that are shifting. What's causing it? CERN. And I really still think CERN's causing it. Could be God. Okay, yes, I still believe there is that great possibility. Because it did say in the Bible that he would give us a new heaven and a new earth, and we certainly got it. The only problem is we keep on getting a new one and a new one. It's not the stuff in the background changing. At first, yes, I thought it was time travel. Yeah, like everybody else, and I've seen so many out there saying people are going back in time and changing shit. After what has just happened to me, we're moving. It's us. We're the ones that are moving. In my reality, from my home world, right, we're called the raptured there. Because here it's called the Mandela effect, because to many of us, we knew that Mandela died in prison. Right? Well, in my world, he did still die. He was still dead when I got back there. So hence, the word Mandela effect didn't even come to pass in my reality, because he never come back to life. So it never got called the thing. One thing too. The bloody quantum computer. There's hardly any talk about a bloody quantum computer on my friggin' reality. Because I ask my daughters about it. I ask my daughters quite a lot of shit. But I do know, I'm pretty sure it was my world, because it was my kids, my film set. Everything was back to normal. The way I'd left it before I come back to this. And as I said, I don't even know that this is the right reality, because we've now got the Great Wall of India. So I believe we've shifted again. I really, truly believe now that we live in such a multiverse where there's thousands of planets in our solar system alone, maybe in even other galaxies. But the whole thing is, you've got to understand, and you've now got to start opening your mind to the word, you are a shifter. You are now a dimensional traveler, officially. Because every time we shift, it's not the stuff. They're not going back in time and changing shit. Or maybe they're trying to. And they might be successfully changing a little bit of shit. But what they're doing, it's shifting us from reality to reality to reality. Right? How could they change the landscape? How can they change a country? They can't. They do not have the physical capability of picking up a country and moving it. Right? One of the things I went and looked at today was my harbour. My harbour's still in the wrong spot. It's still pointing in the wrong spot. Still looks the wrong way on Google Earth. All right? Coastline's a little bit different on Google Earth. Again, the lake's a little bit different. And that's what I said. I don't even think I'm actually back in the same reality that we were in at Christmas. I believe that some of you may have shifted to this reality first. I believe that there is other me's out there that are outspoken as myself. Right? And the journal seems to show that. And it's me just talking to me, leaving messages for me, and I'm just trying to understand what's happening to us and why we're going through what we're going through. Because I know that my house can't just change and have a movie set in it one day. And I mean a proper, full-on built movie set. Because one thing I learned when I was younger was how to build movie props. It was how I got into the film industry. I learned how to make props before I made anything. Right? And then I jump overnight into a reality where everything, it's still the same date, but everything in my home is 12 months behind where I was originally, about 12 months. And I've jumped again, and I've been noticing little differences again since Christmas, like a tidier house. But as I said, like there are notes about how I was untidy in the journal, and he tidied up, and it took him about 3 weeks apparently. I have actually read some comments on my channel about where some of you guys have been wondering where I was, and someone said that they saw me in a chat room and having a chat with somebody saying, what's going on? What's this Mandela effect? And that was one of the guys that was here. And he was a tidy bastard. And that's what I mean. He tidied everything. I couldn't find my mic. I couldn't find my mic stand. I got everything in boxes here at the moment. Oh, I'm a bit of a messy bugger because I was trying to build the movie set again because I still want to make my film. And I guess what? I'm going to make a Mandela effect video, but a movie about what's happening to us. And I believe that down the road that we can do something. But the whole thing is, folks, it's not the stuff around us changing. It's changing because we're going from reality to reality. What is causing it? Yes, it is still a major, major mystery. But it's not just a logo change. It's not just this, it's not just that. That's how you can tell you have shifted again. Right? Some of you are saying, oh, like weird shit's been happening while you've been gone, Bluebeard. But what you guys don't realise is that you have been shifted again. They've taken you from Lego Universe 1 and put you on Lego Universe 2. Right? Whether this is some giant conspiracy where we're the lab rats, and this is some giant psychological experience to see how we're coping. Some aren't coping very well, and trust me, I know some of you aren't coping very well. Right? But you've got to understand, stay hot, stay fast to God. That's all I can tell you. Stay fast to God, because I know that Bible has changed numerous times. And again, it's not the Bible changing. It's just the way the Bible was written this way in this reality. I don't know, actually, do we still have narwhals in this one? I'm going to just bear with me, guys. I'm just going to check. Right, like the narwhals, right? I'm going to call it up. And one thing as well, I noticed that they've found a sister Earth, right? And I think that's how you spell it. Narwhals, result from narwhals. Try that one. Yep, narwhals. We've still got narwhals in this reality. Well, in my reality, we didn't have narwhals, right? So
it's not just little changes. Yes, there's little changes from planet to planet to planet, where people say it has been like that since day one. Nothing's changed. The new earthers, or the, maybe we should start calling them, oh no, we can't call them the original earthers, because then we lose our home. But yeah, to us it's a new earth, and we're going to a new earth and a new earth all the time. Like the movie, movie series, you could call it, or TV series, the movie series, Twist, Shifters, or Sliders, sorry, Sliders, not Shifters, where they're jumping from dimension to dimension to dimension. That's us now. That's our life. Unfortunately, yes, we can go home. Well, I went home to a reality that was almost 100% my home, 100%. And as far as I've got to say, it was my home world. My movie set was the same. My children were my children. But the only difference is my children had gotten together because of what had happened. My children are a family. They now have each other. They never had each other before. They had their mums and their stepfathers, but they didn't have a family of themselves, of brothers and sisters. But now they have each other in that reality. They know where I am. The people of our world will now know what has happened to the people. They will now get some relief, because a lot of them think, okay, maybe we were taken by God, or maybe we were taken by aliens. But now they're going to know the truth. My children have enough video of what happened to me and everything and what really happened to us. And some of it was done in the movie set, some of it was done in lounge room, some of it was done here, some was done there, so that there were different shots and everything like that, because I didn't want everything shot in the bloody movie set. We even shot a video in the kitchen. And but the whole thing is, right, the families were, in my reality, that were all freaking because so many million people disappeared. But you've got to remember, in the reality that I left at Christmas, there were 2 billion people missing from that reality. And people hadn't even come wise to it. Some of the Mandela affected, and I'm going to start using the word affected now, because it's not an effect, it's not shit changing, it's us moving. We're the ones that are sliding or shifting or whatever you want to call it, right? And the whole thing is why and everything. Maybe this is part of the giant galactic plan. There's some people saying we're shifting because we've moved into a higher reality. If we've moved into a higher fucking reality, well, why are some of the realities still fucked? Okay? So explain that one to me, right? You guys have got to wake up even more than the Christians, right? And I'm a Christian, right? But you guys that think, okay, we're moved to a higher plane, for God's sake, wake the fuck up. You're sliding. If you're feeling the Mandela effect and you're seeing these changes, you are being shifted. Right? As I said, I had a weird abduction experience in one of the other ones. And yeah, I still think there's a great possibility that's involved. But I can tell you here and now, the Bible has always been that way in this reality. In this reality. The burn, whatever it is, the burn stain bears in this reality have always been here. Narwhals, right, have always been here. Right, unicorns existed in this reality. And this is what you have to understand, for God's sake. You need to open your friggin' eyes. Remove the veil from your eyes so that you may see. Ask God to do it, because he certainly will. You ask God to remove the veil from your eyes, because this could be part of his plan. This could still be the new heaven and the new earth. Maybe he just hasn't gotten it right. He's still adding a few little things for us. But our world did not get destroyed, okay? To that, now, this one I'm addressing to a few people that are actually up on the message bank at the moment. I'm going through a few of your comments while I'm talking, right? The world did not get destroyed in my reality, okay? Maybe there is a reality where it did, okay? I can't say that, but in my reality on Sagittarius Arm, where Hillary Clinton was president before I even got shifted, right? We were at World War III before I even got shifted. Taured was a country in my reality, right? So you've got to understand, in my reality, we're called the Rapture because the Mandela Effect never got called the Mandela Effect because Nelson Mandela didn't come back to life. The tank guy, and I checked with that one, he still got run over. And I even watched some video of him being run over, right? I've been able to reaffirm my beliefs because I had that small period of time where I went home. And yes, some of you may go back to your original reality. I don't know if you're going to stay there. I hope you do. I pray that we all get home sometime. Maybe there is a greater purpose. Well, what the fuck is going on? Because trust me, I'm fucking freaked out. But I'm not going to lose my head over it. And I've got to admit, there's some of you that need to calm down a little bit because... Now, I'm going to address another one. This is to some people that want to turn around and just make money out of the Mandela Effect. If you just want to make money, admit that you're not taking, not experiencing it and shit like that. Because there are a lot of us that are really fucking experiencing it. And it's real. But if you experience even one slight change, like James Bond girl not having braces in this reality, or Bernstein Bears, or from Bernstein to Bernstein, Narwhals, Great Wall of India, which makes me believe, again, I'm not in the same one I was in at Christmas. The Great Wall of India didn't fucking exist in that world. Right? Now, here's the clinker. Right? I told you I was going to do some research. Right? I've done the similar research in each of the realities. CERN had kicked up. I just found out today that CERN has been shut down for about 3 fucking months. Then all of a sudden, and by the way, this CERN's the most powerful out of all the worlds I've been on. Right? This one has a quantum computer. One of the other ones I spent 7 hours in had a quantum computer as well. And the whole point of it is, right, this is why I still think they are causing this fucking problem. They are trying to find these worlds, but in the process of it, they're moving people unwittingly, but with all the fucking dancing videos, we're happy at fucking CERN. Maybe this is happening because maybe the shifts are not happening because, okay, this has been like this, this has been like that, that's been like that, that's been like that. I think it's more when CERN kicks over, whichever the one is the most powerful at the time. And I think there is something about them being turned on, because I know this one was on but wasn't. I think it was they were just doing the smaller experiments when I got taken away, because I knew they were doing something about Alice or something. And yes, I've read all the stuff in that map about CERN and the Darth Vader and shit like that. This is why I think they know about it. I'm 100% sure they know they're fucking doing this. Right? They're not changing the timeline. They know that this shit is really happening. And they're just bragging about it. Scientists are like that. Scientists like to brag. Right? So you've got to understand that this shit is real. And it's really fucking happening. But it's not the shit around you changing. So you go, I'm watching so many videos today. And I'm seeing, this has changed and that's changed. And you've got to realise, it hasn't fucking changed. You're the one that has been taken from your reality, swapped with this one. Whether or not they're causing a loop, and I've looked at that in theory and trying to work out the physics of it, because, yeah, I understand physics. Some of you might not know that, but I'm actually a very smart fucking man. I always have been. I've studied for 23 years, 12 subjects now, by the way, engineering, electronics, quite a lot. And the whole point is, I believe there may be some kind of loop involved with what's going on, and we're just moving down around the loop. And yeah, I know, yeah, and somebody's going to say, oh, that's CERN, it runs in a loop. Well, maybe that's what's causing it. Giant magnet. One fucking huge giant magnet. All right, if a magnet has the ability to cure fucking headaches and shit like that, and you make a big enough fucking magnet on one planet, make another one on another one, and connect to those fucking universes, and you could be causing all this shit. So all I can say is you've got to wake up, folks. The world around you is not changing. You have been moved to a new reality. Every time you see something different and you know that it wasn't that way in the reality where you just were, right? Or you all of a sudden everyone's back to normal. You may be home in your reality. And yes, I know there's so many that haven't lost family, so many that haven't gained family. But you've got to remember, there are those out there. People who've got different sisters, brothers, husbands, wives. Right? They still exist. This is still happening. Right? And I think it's going to keep on going while these operations are still going. And still going. I hope that when they finally stop this shit, I'm back on my home world and I stay there. Okay, yeah, I know it was a shitty fucking world. We were at war. Well, fair enough, Australia wasn't being fucking bombed, but I can tell you now, the terrorists were a fucking nightmare. But the whole thing is, you guys have all got to realise this shit is real. And you have to wake up. It's not just the fact that the Kit Kat flavour has changed or fucking Jiffy peanut butter's changed. You're the one that has changed. You're the one that has been swapped over, the aliens or fucking whatever entity or whatever machine has picked you up from this one and fucking swapped you. Unwillingly, of course. And as I said, this could be giant, one giant fucking omnipotent being's social experiment. Like, we fuck around with rats and do it to rats. Maybe they're doing it to us. Think about it. So, to hold your sanity, you've got to forget about everything. You've got to forget about all the shit that's going around. Try and continue with your life. Right? I've always, and no matter what reality I have been in, I've tried to continue my life the best I could, except my own, because my kids wouldn't fucking let me go outside because people were just vanishing. My kids were thinking it was the government that were causing them to vanish again. Right? Because, and that's just how my world reacted. Like, a couple of 100 million people just fucking vanish. Then all of a sudden they're popping in sick last 6 months. They're popping fucking back. So yeah, the governments are reacting on my world. Other worlds, we're just being fucking put in place of somebody else. Someone else is coming into the fold. In this reality, it seems like there has been somebody else. I thought this was my original reality because of all the videos that I have made. But I'm starting to see that maybe this is not the same reality that I thought I was back in last night when I made those other three vids. And now find out that there's the Great Wall of India, there's so much other shit that is happening. I'm thinking to myself, fuck, I've been moved to a different reality. Some of you that know me may have been moved here prior to me getting here. And this is what you need to all understand. None of us know where we are. And I know, I don't know where the fuck I am, but I'm not going to do anything fucking stupid. I'm going to research it. I'm getting smarter because of this. Because I'm putting everything I know into what is causing this fucking thing. I have become a researcher of the Mandela Effect. I'm still calling it the Mandela Effect, but I'm just adding a few terms along the way so that people understand what it really fucking is. That bottle of Rexona or that fucking McLean's or McLaren's or McClough or McCliff or McGill or whatever, those names haven't just changed. We have. We have been shifted into another multiverse. Whether or not the CERNs on all the things I believe that they had that one big accident, and I believe that was what fucked everything up. Maybe it happened on every fucking world, and it's upset the multiverse. And maybe this is the way of the multiverse trying to correct itself. I'm praying it is, because I want to go home to my kids, right? Especially now that I've seen them. I know they are still alive, and that's in my heart. It's going to keep me going for fucking ever. But I don't care if I'm stuck here or where I end up. I'm going to try and get fucking back home, or try and solve the fucking problem of why we are shifting realities. There is the cause. We all know the cause. We've got to stop it. And maybe our world will kick their accelerator over. But I believe that this CERN, because I can tell you now, this has got the most powerful one. It's got a quantum fucking computer in it. Maybe this is the same as the other reality. There are strong worlds and there are weaker worlds. And the realities are being affected by the stronger machine. They're pulling people across. Maybe there's something about us in our physical being that's causing this to happen. Maybe there's something about our soul or about our spirit, whatever the fuck is being moved. All I know is we are being physically fucking moved. I've been shifted 80,000 fucking light years and 80,000 light years fucking back again. The other two shifts were still in the Sagittarius arm, by the way. Not back here, fucking back, fucking here, there, fucking everywhere. We could be just simply walking through a door in our homes at night time. When a fucking, I'm not going to call it the lunar wave anymore. I'm going to call it the effect wave. Okay? That wave that everybody says, oh, it's the lunar wave, it's going over the moon. The only time they're seeing it is because the moon is in the fucking background. I've seen it in the clouds. Okay? Keep your eye on the fucking sky all the time. Because I believe this wave is what's is part of the effect. Affect with an A, not an E. And I believe that every time this wave fucking happens, we get shifted along. Maybe man's irrefucking-sponsibility has caused this shit to happen. Today I just found out about a fucking nuclear explosion on fucking Mars. A nuke on Mars. So, shit's weird. And yeah, I can see that everybody says, glad you're back, blue bitch. Shit's been getting real weird since you've been gone. But did you ever think that you just may have been shifted again? It could happen to us tonight. There's no way of knowing which one of us is which, because I believe that every one of us that is being affected, our counterparts are affected. And they're going through this shit the same way. They're trying to cope the same way that all of us are as well. So you've got to think of them. And do yourself a favour. You want to talk to yourself? Keep a journal. Stick it in the fucking safe. You'll find that you're actually talking to your fucking self. And not in the mad way. That someone's actually writing shit in. And how did I know that it's been someone different? Well, on the last two worlds, my own included, right, there was no journal on the last one. There wasn't one in the one, but there was the one before. All right? Now, the whole point is my world now has a journal just in case someone else pops into it. And my kids have been warned. My kids have been given code words, all right, so that my kids know that it is me. Because only I know those code words. So someone else rocks up in my world. But I've told my kids to treat them the same as being me. And not to freak out if they say, oh, we've only got two. Because like they freaked out when I told them about there was only two of them here. And you've got to understand that you need to keep track of what is going on. I keep a journal on medication. Right, because I've got to take diabetic every... Oh, that's one thing that pisses me off. Every fucking world I've been on, I've still got diabetes.
So I've got a journal now, and with that, I keep a journal on the diabetes, so I know that this body is always getting its medicine. Because if I don't take your medicine, it can fuck you over, because your sugar goes down, you can die. You've got to keep a track of it, so you keep a diary. Any diabetic will tell you that. And that's what gave me the original idea for the journal, for what's going on and everything, to see different handwritings within that book. And to know that someone is filling in, someone is feeding my animals, someone is cleaning my fucking house, someone is sleeping in my fucking bed. But it's me, because, and someone at the poker game, people say, oh, I said something, and, oh, yeah, but we did that last week, and we spoke about that last week. I have no fucking recollection of it, because I wasn't fucking here. I've tried to tell them about the Mandela, I just say, oh, fucking, it's just another Mandela effect, don't fucking worry about it. And that's how I explain it, what all the shit and everything, because they say, oh, well, this happened, that happened. And, like friends, when I was in the one that, when I first was affected by the Mandela effect, I had people that were my friends all of a sudden, but weren't my friends prior. And as I've jumped in a couple of different realities and everything like that before I jumped into home, I've noticed that they've either shifted back to not knowing me as well or whatever. And these changes, and some people, I've seen it happen in the chat room. When I've been in the chat room, somebody says, well, this person is no longer the same. They're different. This is why they're different. Because we are shifting. And if that happens to you with another Mandela affected person, don't freak the fuck out. And don't freak them out, for God's sake. All right? Because you've got to realize they are still your friends. They're just from a different version. Try and work with them, help them. And because we need to help each other. Because we are a family. We have to be a family, no matter whether Joe from Universe A has been shifted and then Joe from Universe D jumps in. We've got to treat Joe the same way, because we need each other for the support. And you guys out there have always helped me, trust me. Some of the comments you get and everything, it tells me that I'm not alone in what the fuck is going on. But whatever is going on is picking up. And I think other people are starting to notice it, because a lot of people are saying shit has got real weird since you've been gone. It's just yous have shifted, bang, 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 bang. And yous haven't realised that yet. So all I can say is, folks, hang in there as much as you can. Help each other out. Do what we've been doing since day one. Giving each other, keeping the chat room going, keeping everything going and everything like that. And those of you guys out there that did actually keep the chat room going and everything is one of the reasons why I gave you power in the chat room. And it's sort of because you never know how long and realities are changing. And when one of our friends changed and shit like that, it was, I got told about it. And I thought, well, maybe, yeah, I'll do that. So I'm glad I did it now. But the whole thing is, I've got to actually check the chat rooms and everything. The bills are still being paid, so that's one good thing. So I know that someone's been here, because they're still paying the bills for the chat room. They're still just as, how would you say, they're still me, but they're not me. See, I don't know where the fuck we are. I don't. I'm going to admit it to you very fucking openly. I don't know, guys. I really don't fucking know where the fuck we are. I don't know whether we're in Universe A, Universe D, Universe fucking 437. I don't fucking know. All I know is that we're shifting, and I believe that these constant new changes are not someone going back and changing shit, because, see, the flip-flops are an explanation and proof of it. Because some people say, oh, well, there's a flip-flop. It went back to this way. But Luke, I am your father, jumped back apparently. But then it vanished again. Because we're being shifted. In every reality we get shifted into, things were different from the start. Movies were made differently. Actors were the same. I thought it was a government conspiracy where they were changing shit.
But then it was the landscape, right? See, my landscape is not just that way on Google Earth. It's that way in reality. Because I can drive up there and have a look at the harbour, and I know the harbour. I went out of it thousands of times as a young fella. It's not the same fucking harbour. And you have to fucking realise it. The sooner everybody realises and stop worrying about all the little shit changes, because those little shit changes is everything telling me we have shifted again. We have been physically picked up and moved. It's as if we are Lego pieces or mice in a fucking maze, and we're being picked up from maze one. Let's put them in maze 5000 this week. See how they react. That's pretty much what's happening to us. Whether or not it's being deliberately done, or whether or not it's just fucking happening because of CERN, we don't fucking know. So all I can say is hold fast to what you have, guys, and we'll survive this. I'm pretty sure we will survive it. I haven't picked up any evil intention and of what's going on. It could be God. It could just be God's way of making us ready for the next level. But we don't know. Maybe he's making all these shifts for us. But the multiverse, I'm 100% believer in the multiverse. After seeing what has happened to me over the last 3 months, I'm 100% sure we are part of a multiverse. And CERN has fucked up the reality. See, I don't think they're trying to create a black hole. I think they actually did. And this is the result of the black hole. And it's causing shifts from reality to fucking reality to reality to fucking reality to reality. And it's constant because CERN A on planet UB23 is fucking stronger than CERN F on reality galaxy planet G. Version 296,000. And we're being shifted because one guy's turning theirs on, another guy turns it on, and I think every time one guy fucking turns it on, whichever one's the fucking strongest, we get shifted along. And it's creating havoc with us. Yes, I know. And it's creating havoc with our bodies. But I'll tell you one thing. My internal gut system is getting stronger. I'm still getting gut problems, but my stomach seems to be handling them more. I'm still having other physical medical problems. My back is still worse in this fucking reality than it was in my original reality. No, that's something that was weird too. I went back to just having one thing, and I checked my x-rays. My x-rays didn't have all those little fucking scannable, tiny digital fucking shit on it like they are in this one, because yes, I have checked them since I've been back. They went back just to having the fucking big name shit that they had in my original fucking reality. My equipment looks similar to what I had. But my home is not the same. My set is vanished again. My daughter that was sitting on this very couch, or slash bed, whatever you want to fucking call it, is not sitting there anymore. And to me, that tells me that we are the ones that are fucking moving. And the thing on my planet that we were called the rapture, right? We were taken from 80,000 fucking light years away. And we just vanished. But people have been turning up again for brief periods of time. So this tells me that we are shifting. Maybe there are realities out there, and I think maybe in the Sagittarius arm, my reality wasn't the only one where we were called rapture. Right? If you remember Nelson Mandela not coming back to life and dying, and the tank guy being run over by the tank, and you weren't from my version of reality, and you had or Andorra or fucking Philistine or Palestine or fucking whatever you want to call it, in that same fucking little country.
I believe that some of us were called the rapture, because if Nelson Mandela didn't come back to fucking life and we just vanished, maybe some of them got swapped and just didn't know it. And then all of a sudden people that were raptured are returning. So it wasn't God that did it. So who can it boil down to? C-E-R-N. Nobody fucking else. They know about it because of their fucking videos. We're happy at CERN. Now their fucking tour map that I read this morning says, oh, mirror, mirror on the wall, fucking Darth Vader. And all the other shit in that fucking little fucking tour and brochure you get stamped or whatever they call it. Sorry. I'm just looking at a passport. Their passport. Right? They know about it. But what they were trying to do has fucking caused this ripple in the fucking parallel fucking universe. So all I can say, folks, is I'm going to get as much work out as I can. And after knowing what has happened to me in the last 3 months and the shifts and everything like that, question me. Send messages to me. If I go, if you thing and say, look, okay, if you're not our Bluebeard, ask them where they came from, what they were experienced. Talk to them. They might fucking answer you. They might just not understand what's going on yet. They may have just come from a reality where everything was normal. And then all of a sudden shit has changed. So, and I know you guys are experiencing it as well. Some of you don't know me. Someone said, oh, I had a different name. So in his reality, I was called something else. So you've got to understand that we're all from different versions. And I can tell you now, we are from different versions of Earth. We are constantly on the shift. Why? CERN. And I believe they should be shut down for fuck's sake. I believe they should slowly be shut down on all fucking planets. And everything might just fucking return to normal. I'm praying that that is what happens. But all I can say is, folks, is keep up with the good work. Keep up with the good fight. Do your best. And just last of all, before I go, and I've kept it going back until the thing because I've been hiding it within my videos, is D-Money, if you are a YouTube producer, demonetize your videos because it worked on my reality, right? Demonetize your videos, right? If you put up a video, don't monetize it. Demonetize it, because the more of us that don't let them advertise on our videos, right, the more of us that do it, the quicker YouTube will realize that they're the ones fucking losing money. Right? And I'm sorry, but if you make a fortune out of YouTube and your money's gone downhill, well, you definitely should be fucking demonetized. Just fucking demonetize fucking all of it, for fuck's sake. Yeah, you made a shitload of money. If you made a shitload of money, should have enough money to live on to get you through this shit. But if you don't stand up as well, we're never going to get anywhere with YouTube. They're going to just push us fucking around. I'm telling this to every alternate news fucking channel out there that monetize videos. Stop monetizing your videos because they're attacking you. I know that for a fact. Right? I've read what's going on. I have been updating myself all fucking day watching videos. And the whole point is you guys need to turn around and find out what the fuck is going on. And fight it. And if you fight it, YouTube will have to come good. Once everybody stands up. Remember the old saying, united we stand, divided we fall. Because if we do not fucking unite, they're going to win. And they're going to push us around because they're governed by George fucking Soros, who's most probably sunk a shitload of money into Google. And he's trying to shut down the real media, which is us. And I've got a channel out there. Some of you do know it and everything like that. And I just put out stories and I share some of them even on this channel. You've got to understand that they're the ones being attacked. The ones that are telling the fucking truth. I even mentioned World War III. My videos are not allowed for monetization. Anything I tell about, like the Sandy Hook fucking false flag, anything false flag, demonetized. Not allowed for monetization. Some of my newer videos that I upload, I uploaded one before the text one and everything like that. The first text one didn't upload because I mentioned the word in it. And the whole thing is I put it in the title and went home to World War III. Wasn't even allowed. And you've got to realise this, folks, if you don't stand up and fight for your fucking rights, and there's one way to defeat a big corporation. Stop their inflow of cash. You stop that inflow of cash, they will cave and beg and apologise. They did in my reality. That's how they fought it from where I came from. They were having the same YouTube fucking problem that you are now all experiencing. And you've got to stand up for your fucking rights and you've got to demonetize. Because the quicker we cut off their profit, as I said, they make they make 69%. I think we make 31. I'm unsure of the exact amount. There's other little fees and government taxes that they've got to pay as well. Right, so that part of it gets ripped out of it. They don't get that. But they make a lot more than we fucking make. They make double. Pretty sure they make double what we're getting out of it. So you've got to turn around and cut off their funding. And the advertisers will soon crumble as well because advertisers can't advertise on YouTube. This has been one of their best fucking formats for advertising because it's a lot fucking cheaper than advertising on fucking television. Right, they want to advertise, let them advertise on fucking television. None of us watch the fucking thing anyhow. I know I don't. And the whole point is, folks, you got to stand up for your fucking rights. And yeah, I'll make another video. I've got some more research to do. And as I find more shit, I'll be 100% sure I'm not in the same one I was in December because everything I'm finding out today tells me I'm not in the same version. I don't even know if I've actually been here. If I've been here, I don't know. I didn't know about it because they never mentioned the thing. But I think we're just being shifted from version to fucking version to version to version to version to version. And it's sort of just scary. And it really is. Right? And charity, if I really could bring stuff from my old reality, you know I would. Right? Like when I'm back home, the last least thing from my mind charity when I got home was bringing back a souvenir of my reality. I thought I was fucking home. I didn't know I was going to come back again. I thought I was fucking home. My kids. Like just me was enough for me. And that was all that was on my fucking mind was my children. I'm sorry, charity. I didn't think about you guys, and you know, like, we can't, well, none of us have been successful at bringing anything across with us. We are getting residue, but it's not from us. Somehow it's just coming across as well. It's affected as well. So I don't know how we are affected. I don't know why we are affected, but all I can say is we are. And so you guys can think what you want, those of you that new earthers that have lived here all your life. Yeah, you're getting people visiting your planet on a regular basis. We're being shifted from one version of the thing. Welcome to the multiverse, because the multiverse fucking exists. Some of us come from great deals of difference across the fucking universe. We are still human fucking beings. Oh, one thing I've noticed too is the fucking skull is different. We've now got a new skull again. So, well, this reality has. There's 6 fucking holes in the skull. I actually watched a video about that. I almost forgot to fucking mention it. That one fucking spun me right fucking out.
I've checked the map out again, and there's still a few little changes on Earth, but not so much. These Antarctica shit, that's pretty scary. Maybe there's something to do with Antarctica that's fucking got to do with this. I don't know. And so I'm going to have to go because the pups are whinging. I think they're trying to get out again. So God bless you all, and I'll see you in the next video. And as soon as I find the off button, I'll see you all later. Don't forget to demonetize your videos.